And he'll send it up for Scheifele. A little bit of room down that right side. In for Kopp, scores! The feed by Scheifele, the finish by Kopp. And the Jets lead 1-0.
Great speed on this shift earlier. It's the speed of Ehlers that created a chance for Truba getting into the forecheck. Now it's the speed of Scheifele down the wall, and Andrew Kopp, he'll fit just fine on this line as he scores early in this one, but a good breakout. Truba to Scheifele. Scheifele's just going to take it at two ducks. Go to Scheifele. That leaves the lane open for Kopp. He comes right down the middle with speed. As the Ducks get caught, two guys on one, and Andrew Kopp, a great finish going blocker side for his sixth.
Five-game point streak continues now for Mark Scheifele as it goes from 4-5.
Can't get the puck on the near wall, and Fowler breaks out shorthanded with Logan Shaw. Takes the shot. Shaw converts the rebound, a shorthanded goal.
It's Fowler again. It was all Cam Fowler pressuring the puck up the wall, tipping it past the Jets defenders, and creating the opportunity on the two-on-one. The effort by Fowler, away he goes. They're not going to catch him. He does the right thing, takes the shot, but that's what I was talking about with Andre Pavlik. That is a big, fat rebound for Logan Shaw to sweep into the back of the net. Special teams, such a big part of success, especially when you play on the road, and that shorthanded goal is huge for the... be talking about Josh Morrissey. He's been that good for them this year.
Morrissey's got a couple of goals this season, and Ricard Raquel just pounces on a loose puck and beats Pavlik short side, and the Ducks' deficit not only has been erased, but they've got the lead.
What a shot by Ricard Raquel, but this is not a goal that Andre Pavlik is going to be thrilled about. 20th of the season for Raquel as he remains second only to Sidney Crosby in average goals scored per game played. Just jumps on a loose puck, but he's at the bottom of the circles when he beats Pavlik short side. Remember what I said about unorthodox? There's really no reason for Andre Pavlik, for two things here, to be that deep and to be down on his knees that early.
Corner, Wheeler goes in and steals, trying to get it to Little, but that's grabbed off by Ricard Raquel. He gets to center, and Raquel got dropped by Dustin Buff.
Yep, and Arcan French will talk with another Finn who turned some heads in this city when he was a rookie. Teemu Selänne talks a little bit about Patrick Laine coming up in our second intermission. Hopefully you'll stick around for that as Bernier grabs that one off with the catching glove.
It's a great stop. And this is Kopp, the original goal scorer for the Jets in this game. And Ehlers again penetrates with that speed, dishes it off. And Bernier says,
Time changing has to be careful as Manson off the bench back to play it. Boy, Winnipeg almost had too many on the ice as well. Wheeler comes right in. Bernier point blank. Big stop.
Theodore, second power play of the game for Anaheim. Cross ice and Andre Pavlik, big save off of Ryan Kessler.
Shoot the puck. Doesn't want to see anything too fancy.
Perry gets it back to the point. Tipped in by Getzlaf. Theodore authored the shot, and Anaheim converts on the power play.
Yeah, that's a huge goal for the Ducks, and a real smart play by Shea Theodore at the left point. He saw Getzlaf alone in front and just snapped it down there and just zipped it right along the ice. Watch Getzlaf come out of the corner. Look at the space he has. Toby Enstrom lost him, couldn't get back to defend against Getzlaf, and he just pulls it back against the grain.
Perry won a puck battle and got it back to the point. And Anaheim has a power play goal and a two-goal lead.
Yeah, that's just...
Enstrom will drop it back. Nikolai Ehlers to the line. And in, Ehlers with some room. Scores! Nikolai Ehlers fires it into overdrive. And the Jets are within one as Ehlers has gone back-to-back-to-back with goals.
Coming in, he's so dynamic. That's what makes him special, is speed like this. The Ducks get crossed up, they try to stack up. You can't stack up against speed. You get caught flat-footed, you're not going to stop somebody coming full. As Ehlers is going to swing, it comes off the bench underneath, little drop play, and all the Ducks are going to stand still. Shaw gets caught in the wrong position. That allows Ehlers to lay in as he's getting tripped up. Nice little move. see those two strides, the crossover for speed, a couple more strides, takes it to the net, and puts the backhand home.